All right, so we've learned that the abundant life is a yielded life. The abundant life is a life of service. The abundant life is a separated or sanctified life. The abundant life is a spirit-filled life. And today we're going to talk about the abundant life is a mature life. Now, if you look in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 2, it says, "As newborn babes, desire the pure milk of the word that you may grow thereby." God wants his children to grow up. Look with me at Hebrews chapter 5 and verse 12. "For though by this time you ought to be teachers, you need someone to teach you again the first principles of the oracles of God, and you have come to need milk and not solid food. For everyone who partakes only of milk is unskilled in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. But solid food belongs to those who are full age, that is, those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil." God wants his people to grow up. Amen. Look with me at 1 Corinthians chapter 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 3. Paul says here, he said, "I, brethren, could not speak to you as to spiritual people, but as to carnals, as to babes in Christ. I fed you with milk and not with solid food, for until now you were not able to receive it, and even now you are still not able, for you are still carnal." Do you see that? When we are tied up in the things of the world, when we are so focused on the things here rather than spiritually growing up into him, We're babes in Christ. Now, the Bible speaks of four different stages of our spiritual growth. For instance, right here in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, it talks about the fact that we're a babe in Christ. Now, all of us know that a baby is only concerned about himself. If he's denied the things he desires, he will raise a ruckus, right? He seeks his own. Its feelings are easily hurt. And it is often jealous. A baby lives to be served. It never serves. And by the way, remember we said that an abundant life, part of an abundant life is one of service. Amen. It never makes sense. These infant characteristics are so prominent in the lives of many church members. They have been born into the family of God, but have failed to develop spiritually. They are spiritual babies, carnal Christians. We read that. Another stage is the little child stage. 1 John chapter 2, verse 12 speaks of it. Some Christians grow to be little children spiritually, but stop there. Here are some of the characteristics of children. They are often untruthful, envious, and cruel. If rebuked, they become martyrs. If crossed, they are resentful and often make a scene. They are talebearers, repeating everything they hear. In adults, it's called gossip. They are given to emotional outbursts and are easily puffed up. They love praise and will accept it from anyone. They seek only the things that appeal to self. Are you a spiritual child? Let's move on. The next stage is the young man stage. Again, that comes from 1 John chapter 2 and verse 13. Spiritual growth to that of a young man is not reached by many. Isn't that sad? He is strong and virile and is well able to overcome his enemy. He has a vision for the future and a faith that and courage to tackle it. He is preparing for his productive years. You too can become a young man spiritually by putting away childish things. That's spoken of in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. We need to put away childish things and grow. Finally, the father stage comes from 1 John chapter 2 and verse 13. This stage of spiritual development can be reached by all, but so few ever attain it. The spiritual father has peace with God. Comes from Romans chapter 5, verse 1. He knows the peace of God, Philippians chapter 4, verse 7, the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. He rejoices in his spiritual children. 1 Thessalonians 2:19 and 1 Timothy 1:2. He has learned contentment under all circumstances. Philippians chapter 4, verse 11. See, Paul says, I have learned to be content in whatever state I'm in. He knows that he knows the only source of true strength, which comes from Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. Remember, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. He does not brood over the past, but looks to the future. Philippians 3, 13 and 14. He knows that all things work together in his life for his eternal good. That's Romans chapter 8, verse 28. And he rejoices. He enjoys abundant life now and will enjoy it in the life to come. Ephesians 2:7. Now, once again, see, we need to grow up into Christ, but so many don't. And if you notice, how do we do that? We feed on the pure milk of the Word, but then we become adults and we begin to eat or feed on the meat of the Word. We get in and we become teachers and we do the things to cause us to be mature Christians, having children, spiritual children of our own. Hey, I'm Keith Brown. This is Tack Room Devotional. I love you. Jesus loves you. I pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek Him and serve Him.